time to write the bills out again. First, I'll write one for the church, I guess.
What do you want to do that for?
Who are you?
Well, I'm the Dark Lord of the Underworld. But you can call me Lucifer. Or Lucy, for short.
I know I shouldn't eat that fruitcake.
Wow! You're giving that much?
Yeah, why?
Well, you need that money, Carl. You should buy something nice for yourself. God doesn't need that money. He already has enough.
But God does need the money. He needs it to further his kingdom.
Well, what about you, Carl? You need a new roof. A new car. Why don't you just use that money for yourself?
Well, I see your point. I guess God doesn't need that money. He does have enough money. I could skip this week. It won't hurt anything. I'd save up for that new car. Yeah, get a Mustang.
Yeah! More power!
Yeah, that's a good idea. I think I'm just going to skip a few weeks, and then I'll save up for that car.
The road is wide, and it is waiting for you. Now give me your money! I mean, buy that new car, Carl.
What are you doing?
I'm great. Another voice. I think I need a shrink.
You can't do this! That is God's money, and you should give some back to him!
But I do need a new car.
Well, do you need an expensive one, like a Mustang?
Well, you could get a Corvette if you want.
No, I don't think that was the question. I guess I don't need to get the Mustang.
All right, Corvette. I love Corvettes. You get a red one, a convertible.
No.
What? Why not?
I don't need a convertible. No Corvettes. All right. I guess I could just get a used car, something a lot cheaper. That would be a lot better. But I work hard for my money, and I want something to show for it.
But it's not your money!
But it's my name on the account.
Well, think of how you got that money, Carl. God gave you the ability to do your job so you could get that money.
Well, I guess you're right.
Well, you got your Bible over there, Carl. Why don't you turn to 2 Corinthians 9, 6-8?
Okay. Remember this. A farmer who plants only a few seeds will get a small crop. But the one who plants generously will get a generous crop. You must make up your own mind as to how much you should give. Don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure, for God loves the person who gives cheerfully. And God will generously provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. I see what you're saying. I need to give this money to God.
Well, it looks like my work is done here.
Look, Carl, I thought we'd been through this once. You just don't get it, do you?
No, you're the one that don't get it. See, keeping that money for myself and not giving it to God, that's just like giving it to you. And I don't want to give it to you.
Well, be that way, Carl.
Back to the bills.
Hey, Carl, what about a boat?
No.